Hey guys, once again, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to create an awesome looking gradient typography kind of a motion graphics inside of DaVinci Resolve without using any third-party plugins. My name is Vikash, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 17 edit page, and before we get started, we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. You can select 4K resolution as well from here, and now we have to select a frame rate. So in this case, I am using this 30 frame per second, which is good enough, but you can select any frame rate that you like according to you, and then click on save. Now let's take a new fusion composition because I want to create this animation inside of this fusion page. So just go to this media pool by clicking on this button, right click on this media pool, and here we have the new fusion composition option. So just click on this new fusion composition and let's create a new composition. You can call it anything, and duration make it 5 seconds long, which is good enough. You can increase or decrease the duration from here and then click on create. Now just drag this fusion composition on this timeline just like that, and then you can go to the fusion page, and here we have this media out node. So just drag this media out to the side for now, and we need only one viewer for this animation, so you can click on this single viewer. Now let's start by creating a background. So this is the background button. Let's drag and drop on this flow window, drag this background to the viewer. I'm going to create a gradient background, so it's very simple. Just go to this inspector window, and here we have the type. So let's change this to gradient, and here we have two different color. Let's make it black first, and this is the first color. Just click on this point and let's select a dark blue color just like this, and you can change the gradient type, maybe radial. And now let's down the color value and set the value maybe 0.25 in blue color value. Alright, and you can set the graph just like this. Now we have the perfect background. Alright, after that let's create animated pattern. So it's very simple. You have to click on this background, and let's take a new solid color. You can select the white color, and we have to attach any shape layer. So this is the rectangular shape, the ellipse tool, and the polygon tool, but I'm going to use this ellipse tool for this. So let's drag and drop on this flow window, attach this ellipse with this background, and we will get something like this. Now here we have some properties. So here we have the border width. Let's uncheck the solid and make it like this. You can increase the border width. I'm going to set the value 0.02 like this. Now you can adjust the size of this. So select the ellipse. Here we have the width and height. So I'm going to set the width value maybe 0.25 and height value 0.25. Now I'm going to animate the circle. So just go to on frame number 30, which is equal to 1 second according to 30 frame per second, and let's animate the size. So right click on this width, click on animate, right click on this height, click on animate, and lock the value as it is. Go to very first frame of this animation and let's set the width value 0, height value 0, and then we have the linear animation, but we have to make this animation smoother. So what we have to do, just go to spline window. Here we have the ellipse, so hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, check this option ellipse 1, and let's select one by one. So for the first time, let's check this width, click on fit. Here we have both the keyframes, select these keyframes, hit S to smooth, set the CTI at very beginning of this animation, maybe on frame number 0. Hold this handle and create a nice and simple smooth curve just like this. Hold the second handle and place it over here maybe. Now we have to do the same thing with this height. So uncheck this width, check the height, click on fit button, select both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button. Hold this first handle, let's set it like this. Hold the second handle and set it like this. And then you can close the spline window. Now we have to animate the position of this circle. So just go to the end of this animation. Let's set the circle right over here. Set the center X value maybe 0.25 and center Y value 0.45. Just like this. Alright, and then you can click on this diamond button to create a keyframe at the end of this animation, or you can also right click and click on animate. Alright, and then go to very first frame of this animation, and now you can change the center X value and set it 0.75 and leave the center Y value as it is, and now you will get this type of animation, which is looking nice. Alright, and now let's create the pattern. So select the background, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename. You can call it circle. Select the circle, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for displace. So this is the displace node. Select this one, hit add button, drag this displace to the viewer. And now we have to create animated noise. So hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for fast noise. So this is the fast noise. Hit add button. Let's attach the output of this fast noise with the displace 1, just like this. Now select the fast noise. You can click on this double viewer. Just drag the fast noise in the first viewer. Now select the fast noise, go to the inspector window, go to the color tab, and here we have the alpha. Let's turn on the alpha, just like this. Now you can go to the noise. Let's do some setting. So here we have the details. Let's set the details maybe 1. Contrast, set it to 5. Brightness, leave it as it is. Let's down the scale value and set it maybe 10. Alright, and now we have to animate the seat. So just go to the end of this animation, set the seat value 3, right click on seat, click on animate, go to very first frame, and let's set the seat value 0. And now we will get this type of animated noise. Alright, and here we get the effect. You can click on the single viewer now. Select the displace, and here we have the refraction strength. You can increase and decrease the value. So I'm gonna set the value maybe 0.15, all right, or maybe 0.12, and we will get something like this. After that, select this displace, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for duplicate. So this is the duplicate node. Hit add button, drag this duplicate to the viewer, select the node and go to the inspector window, and here we have the copies. So I'm gonna set the number of copies maybe 25, and let's set the size 1.025 and set the angle maybe 5 degrees, and we will get something like this, which is looking nice. And now we have to fill the color inside of this pattern. So it's very simple. We have to take a new background node. So this is the background button. Let's drag and drop a background node over here. And now we have to take a new merge node. I'm gonna use this output as a background and this one as a foreground, and here we have 4 different points inside of this merge node. So this is the yellow point for background, green point for foreground, and this is the output, and this is the effect mask. So we have to connect the yellow background point with this duplicate 1 output and the foreground point with this background. And now just drag this merge 1 to the viewer, and we will get something like this. So select the merge node, and here we have the operator. Let's change this over to in, and we will get the color inside of this pattern. Now select the background, hit F2 on the keyboard, you can call it color, hit enter, select the color node, go to inspector window, let's change the type solid color to 4 corner, And here we have the top left corner. Let's select the yellow color. Second top right corner, maybe this color. Now select the third color, maybe orange, and fourth color, maybe purple. Hit OK. And now we will get this type of gradient color. Just select the color, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for CC, it means color corrector. Add one more node, hit F2, you can call it CC in the short form. Select the node and go to inspector window. You can increase the saturation value. So I'm going to set the value maybe 1.4, and you can switch the color from here, just like this. After that, we have to add the glow effect. So select the final output, merge one, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for glow. This is the glow effect. Hit add button, drag it to the viewer. Now you can increase the glow. So here we have the value 0.8. Now let's set the value 0.85. After that, let's merge this output with the background. So it's very simple again. You have to take a new merge node, and I'm going to use this background as a background, this output as a foreground. Just drag this merge to the viewer, and we will get something like this, which is looking very nice. All right, and now we have to add a text right over here. So it's very simple. Let's take a text node, drag it on this flow window. Let's take a new merge node. Hold shift on the keyboard and attach this merge node right over here, just like this. And then we will get this green point. Let's connect the green point with the text. Now select the text one and type anything, whatever you like, just like this. Now you can select any different font style, whatever you want. So in this case, I'm using my favorite font style, Century Gothic. Let's set it to regular. You can increase the size. So I'm going to set the value maybe 0.13. All right, and we have to animate the text as well. So just right click on this preview window, go to guide and turn on the guide. Now let's set the text in the center, just like this. After that, we have to animate the text. So just go to on 1 second, maybe on frame number 30. Right click on size, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation, set the size 0, and we will get this type of scale animation. Now go to the end of this animation, let's set the tracking value 1.4 maybe, and right click on this tracking, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation, and then you can set it to default. So we will get this type of text animation. You can click on fit button, select the text, go to spline window, hit F4 to full screen. Now you can minimize all the nodes and check the text only. Open the text. Here we have the size and character spacing. So let's check the size first. Click on fit. Select both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve, just like this. Hold the second handle and set it like this. Close the spline window and then go to very first frame, and here we will get this type of awesome animation. Now let's do one more thing. Let's create a gap over here, and I'm going to create mask over here. So let's take a new background node, hit F2, you can call it matte. Select an ellipse mask and attach this ellipse with this matte. Now you can create a mask around the text, just like this. After that, we have to attach this matte with this pattern animation. So just deattach this connection first. Let's take a new merge node. I'm gonna use this matte as a background and this output as a foreground. So connect the yellow background point with this matte, green foreground point with this glow output. Now you can create a space, and then you can drag and drop this merge 4 to the viewer. After that, Select this merge and change this over to in. Now select the ellipse, and here we have the invert option, so check this option invert. Now you can increase the softness as is. So I'm gonna set the value 0.8 or 0.1 maybe, like this, and then you can connect the yellow point with this merge 4, and finally you will get the output perfect. And now we have to connect the media out with the main output. So this is the media out, and here we have the main output. Let's connect this with the media out, and then you can go to the edit page, and here we will get the final animation, which is looking nice. Now let me show you how you can customize these animations. So it's very simple. Select the fusion composition, hit Ctrl C to copy, place the CDI at the end of this, hit Ctrl V to paste, and this is the second composition. Now you can place the CDI on the second composition, go to the fusion page, and here you can change the text. So this is the text node, and you can type anything whatever you want. Just like this, you can change the color. So here we have the color corrector. Let's change the hue value. You can change the patterns. So here we have the displace option. Select the displace, and you can change the value. So I'm gonna set the value maybe 0.2, and if you will get a different pattern, you can change the value 0.25 maybe. Alright, and we will get a different pattern. Or you can also replace the ellipse tool. So you can replace with the rectangular shape or any triangular or any kind of polygon shapes. Now you can go to the edit page, and here we will get another animation which is looking awesome. Alright, now just turn on the loop button, go to very first frame, hit Ctrl F to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.